Let's talk about Steam tags. If you want to put your game on Steam, it's important to get the tags right so that Steam will show your game to the right customers. Tags are also an easy way to optimize your store page, and there are some noteworthy ways for how you can get some extra juice out of them. In this video, I will go through everything you need to know how to set up and optimize your tags on Steam. Hi, my name is Auro. I'm a full-time indie game developer, creator of Mortal Glory, and currently working on a game called Chambers of Devious Design. On top of that, I also make these weekly YouTube videos sharing my experiences to help you on your own game dev journey. Okay, let's talk about Steam tags. Tags are one component that Steam uses to fuel their search and recommendation engines. Because of that, tags are important to get right, as they will determine where your game gets shown on Steam and to whom your game gets recommended to. If your game has inappropriately selected tags, it will get recommended to the customers who are not very likely to play games such as yours, and you will lose sales because of that. Each game on Steam can have up to 20 tags to describe the game. Or well, you can actually have more than that, but Steam will use only the first 20 tags, so there isn't really a point in having more tags than that. But you should absolutely use all 20 of them. This way, you will give Steam a good idea what your game is all about, so they can recommend it to the right customers. There are two ways you can set tags for your game: through the tag wizard and also manually from your game's Steam page. Let's first check out the tag wizard, which you can open from your game's setup page. Here, you can pick tags one by one from varying types of categories like genres and themes. Once you get to the end, the wizard will give you a recommendation for how to order the tags you selected, and also give you a short preview of some games that have similar tags. There are a couple of things to note here. First, about the games that are shown on this page. If you do go with these tags, that doesn't mean your game will automatically be shown next to those games. Other things like popularity and sales also play a role. What this list means is that these games have very similar tags as the ones you have selected. In practice, it's a good sign if similar games are shown on that list, and it is more likely your game will be recommended to players who have played those games and other games like them. Secondly, the tag order that Steam recommends here is not based on some high-level arcane magic. It's just a simple algorithm that puts the high information tags on the top and the low information tags on the bottom. In this context, a high information tag means that it's more definite and gives a better understanding of a game than a low information tag. For example, turn-based strategy is a high information tag, whereas single player is a low information tag. Both can describe your game, but the other one certainly gives a better idea what your game is about. As the algorithm suggests, you should have the high information tags on top. The tags are weighted, meaning that Steam will value the ones on top more than the ones on bottom. That's why you want to have the tags that describe your game the best on top, as Steam will put more emphasis on those tags when it decides where to show your game. In Steamworks documentation, it says that the top 5 tags should paint a fairly clear picture of your game. So that's what you should aim for. Usually the tag wizard can give a pretty good order for the tags, but it's based on a simple algorithm that doesn't know your game at all. So don't be afraid to adjust the order by yourself. Try to put the tags on top that are more specific and fit your game the best. At this point, it's good to take a look at other popular games also that are similar to yours. If you notice that many similar games put the tags in specific order, it might be a good idea to copy that order so your game is more likely to be shown next to those games, assuming that those same tags apply to your game. Speaking of other games, in the Steamworks documentation, you can find a tidbit of information that when Steam recommends games, the order of the tags is not as relevant as the amount of overlapping high information tags between the games. So the more tags your game shares with another game, the more likely it is to be recommended to players who enjoy that other game. While the order might not play that big of a part in the recommendations, I think it's still a good idea to somewhat mimic the attack order of similar popular games, as the order still affects where your game is shown. Okay, that was the tagging wizard. I mentioned that you can also set the tags manually. There are a few reasons why you'd want to do it manually. The first reason is that if the tagging wizard is not working properly for some reason, the manual way should do the trick. I recently had a situation where I was not able to find a few specific tags in the tagging wizard, so I had to go ahead and add them manually. After that, I could see them in the tagging wizard also. I don't know if it was a temporary glitch or if it had something to do with my Steam page being unpublished, but whatever the reason, I was able to handle it by setting the tags manually. Another reason why you might want to check the tags manually is that the players actually have an ability to affect your tags on your Steam page. If enough players apply an existing tag to your game, that tag will get bumped up in the tag order. And likewise, if enough players add a certain new tag to your game, that tag will appear on the tag list of your game. This might cause issues if you have carefully adjusted the tag order by yourself. But the good news is that in the tag section on your Steam page, you can actually remove tags that have been set by players. While the players can affect the tags, you as a publisher have the final say on what the tags should look like. It's a good idea to check the tags now and then in case some unwanted tags have risen too high thanks to the player tagging. For example, if a low information tag like action has risen near to the top, or if your player base consists of trolls and they have added a nudity tag to your Tetris clone. If you're having trouble coming up with descriptive tags, checking other similar games is always a good idea. And there are also a few resources that you can use. First of all, you can check the popular tag section on Steam to get ideas. In the Steamworks documentation, you can also find a list of all the tags that are available to you. I wouldn't recommend adding tags that don't describe your game well though, as that could lead up to a negative customer experience and less sales for you since your game is being shown to the wrong customers. There are also some tags you might want to avoid if they are not a core part of your game. Chris Tchaikovsky had a good point in his article about Steam tags, that some players might be very hesitant on entering your store page if they see tags like violent, blood, or gore. Of course, it's a good idea to use those tags if your game is very violent, but those tags might be overkill if your game just shows a bit of low-res pixel blood. Then, if you step outside of Steam, there are some materials available on the internet also, like this graph made by Quantic Foundry, which visualizes how popular all the tags are and what their relations to each other are. So basically, which tags are often used together. This graph is from 2018 though, so there probably have been some changes after that to the tags and their popularity. But it could still give some ideas. Also, maybe there is a newer similar graph available that I didn't notice with a quick Google search. As another handy external resource, you might also want to check steamlikes.com. It shows you which games on Steam feature your game in their more like this section. With this tool, it's pretty interesting to see how the tags and your game's popularity are affecting your game's visibility in practice. One caveat with this site is though that Steam is changing things on their end from time to time, so there have been times when the site has been not fully accurate. But at least now, when I checked it, it seemed to be working just fine. And that's where I will end this video. I would love to hear if you learned something new about using tags on Steam from this, or if you have some tips of your own to share. Alright, thanks for watching and I'll see you on the next one.